Batman. Three Jokers. Issue 1 of 3. Published by DC Comics. Finally, after 4 years of teasing, Batman Three Jokers Issue 1 from the creative team of writer Jeff Johns, artist Jason Fabok, and colorist Brad Anderson is here. Since 2016, I have waited to see the payoff to the mystery of the Three Jokers revealed by the Mobius chair. That is a bit longer than Doomsday Clock. And speaking of which, like Doomsday Clock, this Three Jokers book appears to be out of continuity. Sadly. Although, given how awful the current DC universe is, and how death metal and Year of the Villain ruin everything that DC Rebirth had been setting up, I don't mind. I actually welcome this story and Doomsday Clock being divorced from that awful continuity and being standalone. In fact, Three Jokers appears to be more in Doomsday Clock's continuity than anything else going on in the DCU. What do I mean by that? Well, Three Jokers and Doomsday Clock are both written by J.F. Johns and visually and aesthetically and narratively, they're very visually consistent to each other. And both series do appear to be in their own separate world, and for that they're stronger for it. The most apparent example of this are the bat suits worn by Batman and Batgirl in both series. During issue 9 of Doomsday Clock, we see Batgirl wearing the same suit that she's wearing in Three Jokers. It is a much more simpler black suit with yellow accents for the emblem, yellow boots, and yellow inner cape lining. It looks very cool. It's actually my favorite Batgirl suit so far. It is like a callback to the classic 1960s Batsuit, but with a much simpler color palette. That makes her look more uniform to Batman's own Batsuit. And the suits that Batman and Batgirl wear in Doomsday Clock and Three Jokers, they are unique in that they don't wear them in any of the main continuity series being published right now. So that's more evidence than that these two stories are in the same continuity, separate from the main one. And personally, I love the character designs. Batman always looked better with the yellow oval. And I love how in this issue his oval has a secondary function as a lantern. The primary function being to deflect bullets, because the yellow oval, as revealed in Detective Comics issue 1000, the yellow oval contains the gun that was used to kill Bruce's parents. The gun was melted down and turned into a chest plate that is hidden inside the oval. I also like the character design for Red Hood. He's a character that I despise. Well, at least his post-crisis incarnations. The only version of Jason Todd that I like is the pre-crisis Earth One. Red Hood's costume is cool and strongly resembles a modified Robin suit. That callback to the Robin suit is actually pretty intentional, as in the climax of this story, we have a climactic confrontation at the Gotham Aquarium. In that scene, Batman, Batgirl, and Red Hood have captured one of the Three Jokers, who is identified as the Clown. Batman leaves to capture another one of the Jokers, because the Three Jokers, they committed a crime simultaneously that same night. And so, he leaves Red Hood and Batgirl alone to interrogate the clown Joker. It is then that the clown Joker starts taunting Jason Todd about the revealing that he was the one who killed Jason all those years ago during a death in the family in the 1988, I think. So he ends up taunting Jason and even reveals that during Jason's final moments, and Jason even bargained for his life, telling the Joker if he let him leave, he would become his psychic and abandon Batman. That's pretty heavy stuff. And more reason I do not like post-crisis Jason Todd. The comedian Joker's taunting becomes so much, and it goes so far that pretty much Jason just says, "Slime it," and shoots the comedian Joker in the head. When I saw that, I was like, "Am I slime? He killed the Joker, finally! Somebody killed the Joker at last!" But then I remember, oh wait, there's two more. So there's two Jokers left. So the Joker that died in this issue was the clown Joker. He had been the one from the Silver Age, I believe. The one who did all the pranks and used all the gadgets, and who had the henchmen, and most famously did the Joker fish story. And infamously, he was the one who killed Jason by beating him with a crowbar and blowing him up inside a warehouse. The remaining two Jokers are the Golden Age original, who is identified as the leader of the Jokers, and he's known as the Criminal. And the other one is the 1980s iteration that shot Barbara Gordon in The Killing Joke. And that one is the most sadistic of the three, and he's known as the Comedian Joker. So the setup for this story is very exciting. Was it worth the wait? Of course it was! I'm very looking forward to seeing just what they're planning, because the Criminal Joker, the leader of the trio, he told the other two that their plan was to create a new Joker. And with what happened in this issue with Jason killing the clown Joker, it seems that the Criminal wants Jason to become fourth Joker. That's another reason why I believe this is out of continuity, because in the main continuity, something like this would never happen. This takes a lot of guts. Oh, and before the scene that I describe at the Gotham Aquarium, there was a build-up to it, where Batman, Batgirl, and Red Hood, they first enter the aquarium, and they pass by these tanks. And inside the tanks were a bunch of Joker fish, but also a Joker shark. I was like, what? A Joker shark? That's new. And it was so scary and cool. And the Joker shark actually appears in my two favorite panels from this issue. Let's take a look. See what I mean? Those panels are so cool. So, final verdict. Munch it. Also, how fun is it that issue 3 is going to be coming out in time for Halloween? That's very appropriate in my opinion. Anyway,
Thank you for watching. See you next time. Au revoir. Also,
and bat's meal.
Batman, Three Jokers, Issue 1 of 3.
Excuse me. Night, night.